So I'm just going to switch gears right now. Toronto media, social media, the press, through this massive tragedy that happened on Sunday last week, where a young guy, you know, went from celebration to total tragedy, and his life will never be the same as the people that he affected. I'm just regurgitating what I've read. He was at his own celebration in Las Vegas because he's getting married, where he was scheduled to get married, and came back on a private jet. He comes from a very well-off family, and they continued the celebration after the flight got in, and he got in his vehicle intoxicated. I believe it's twice the limit allowed, and drove through an intersection and hit a minivan, T-boned the back, and killed four people, a grandfather and three children, the grandchildren of the grandfather. And the grandmother was in the front with the great-grandmother, and they're still in hospital, but they believe that they will survive their injuries. So if you take a look at everybody's viewpoint on this, you know, the press has gone after every aspect of this man's life. His mother's being criticized for some video she made for some show where she talked about not liking driving a Porsche Standard because it got in the way of wearing nice high-heeled shoes, and she had to switch gears so she couldn't smoke and talk on a phone, or couldn't smoke and drink. No, sorry, it was nothing about the phone. Couldn't smoke and drink her coffee. So they're all over her on that, and you know, I'm going to give you my point on all of this, and then you guys can jump in. The family that lost the three children and the very young grandfather and the two injured, I don't want to imagine it. It must be, and you can never recover for something like that. It's just unbelievable, brutal. And but he also is finished. And I don't care if he gets the best legal team in the world. There's very, very difficult for me to see that they're going to be able to argue the compelling evidence from the scene of the crime. I'm going to call it a crime, from the scene of the accident, but it is a crime. And he's going to do a lot of jail time. His life is finished. And he's also, not only out of this reckless, crazy, worst decision that he's ever made in his life, he's also destroyed his family. And the problem that I'm having right now is how vicious all the people are. You know, it's almost this mob mentality. I mean, he's been caught. He's in jail. And you know, he doesn't have to be tarred and feathered in 2015. He's gonna go through what he has to go through. He's going to jail. There's no way anybody's going to buy him anything. If I was his lawyers, I would definitely try to make some sort of deal with the Crown on at least saving him some time in prison if he's going to get 25 years, which I've been reading on the Internet. I'm not saying there's a rule of thumb, but which is a crime now, it's a very bad crime, and it's looked upon 20 years ago as no big deal, but now it's pretty serious. And, you know, if somebody dies because of a person's drunk driving, they're looking at 5, maybe 10 years per person. So there's 4 people who died, plus 2 people got injured. So he's looking at a life sentence. And I'm sure that that's what the Crown's going to go after. So if he wants to avoid a very emotional and brutal trial, they need to make some sort of arrangement and settlement where he's going to go with for 15 years or 6 years, whatever they decide, and some sort of restitution to the tragic event that he put on this planet for that family. But, you know, this mob mentality to go after his family didn't do anything. And it's no crime to be rich in this country.
No.
This country gives. This country gives everybody an opportunity to be what they possibly can be. And his grandfather, which I knew, I was not best friends, but I had met the man, incredible man, a man of honor. His word was his bond, and gave a lot to his community, and was a philanthropist, not only a very successful businessman. It's no crime to be rich. What he did, it's on his shoulders. And his family is, I'm positive they're devastated.
Oh, I would say so, Frank. I mean, your point's well made. Marco Muzzo, whom I knew as well, had dinner with he and his wife through a mutual friend, very, very nice people, made a lot of money, worked very hard to make it, and now he's got a son who made a big... A grandson who made a big mistake. And I went through this with Rob Ramage, who I considered to be as nice a young man as I'd ever met. He went to Keith McCreary's funeral, and the night before, he and all the players who knew Keith, the guys who had played with him, against him, had a party. And I assume they must have consumed alcohol till into the wee hours, let's say 4 or 5 in the morning. I don't know. The next day was the funeral. There was no drinking at the funeral. That was testimony. Now they have to drive the car back to the airport. And Keith Magnuson, who is Rob's close friend, couldn't drive. Let's just leave it at that. It was his car. Rob drove the car. When he's driving along one of the major thoroughfares, east and west, and it was a snowy, icy day, Keith, who has a propensity to slap a guy on the shoulder and say, "Hey, Rammer, you're a great guy." He did that. The car ended up going sideways. It was T-boned. And Keith died. And Rob was hurt badly, but not to the point of life-threatening. Now he goes to court, and he has a trial. And I was so annoyed with the judge when he gave Rob Ramage 4.5 years. And to your point, Frank, that was at least 7 or 8 years ago. This hasn't gone down, and the people who run MAD, M-A-D-D, Mothers Against Drunk Drivers, you better be sharp to around them, because I'm with you, Frank. It'll be 5 years for each tragedy, and they're going to have to make some kind of a deal that might mean 10 years with no parole. This is going to be a tough one.
Well, he's not going to get 10. But he'll get less than 25 if he makes a deal. But there's no way a crown is going to, or a judge is going to put their credibility on the line by giving this guy 10 years. There's no way.
No, I don't disagree with you, Frank.
I'm just saying to you that it is.
There's a lot of money in
tragedy. I can't believe it.
A lot of lawyers.
My heart goes out to everybody here. But this mob mentality of everybody, you know, they open up a Facebook page to get signatures to put this guy away forever. You know, he is guilty.
Yeah, but
what he did was extremely reckless and stupid. And here I'm going to talk about from somebody who likes their wine, who doesn't mind a glass of scotch. You, even if you feel good, but you've drank, even if you feel then you're not wobbling and you're not there, you will make bad decisions when you're driving. So I get a car. I get a car to pick me up and drop me off.
It's called responsibility.
Yeah, but it's
I'm
also...
with, like, yeah, I mean,
why would you put yourself in that position? For what, especially somebody in his position where he could have afforded 15 cars to pick him up. He could have afforded a gold chariot.
Yeah.
This is a high-profile case. You know, this is a family, an empire with a lot of money. A lot of people are going to be watching.
But a lot of money is not going to save him on this one here.